मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? फाइन, ओके, वेरी गुड. नाउ इज द टाइम ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स इन विच वी शैल डिस्कस ए लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इन यस्टरडे डिस्कशन वी केम टू नो अबाउट डिफरेंट फंक्शंस ऑफ मनी. And we discussed these functions in detail, categorized as primary function, secondary function, and contingent or other functions. Okay. Now, students, today we shall discuss about the supply of money. Already we have seen why money is needed in an economy. Okay, money is needed in an economy mainly for exchange, mainly for measurement of value, mainly for a store of value, mainly for making deferred payments, etc., etc. Okay, so the amount of money which is available in an economy in its circulation at a point of time is called supply of money. Okay, that means when we say the supply of money, that refers to the quantum, total quantum of money or the stock of money available in circulation of an economy at a point of time, that is called supply of money. Supply of money is a stock concept, and velocity of money is a flow concept. Okay, do you understand what is called velocity? Velocity of money means the number of times an unit of money rotates in circulation from one person to another person, that is called its velocity. Suppose you are having a 100 rupee note and you buy vegetables by spending this note. Okay, the person from whom you have bought your vegetables receives rupees 100 from you, and suppose that person buys another thing, say sweets from someone, and gives the same 100 rupee note to that person. Okay, then here three times 1 rupee note has rotated from one person to another, from you to that person who was selling vegetables, and from that person to that person who was selling sweets, etc., etc. Then here the velocity of money will be called as 3, because 3 times it has rotated from one person to another. Okay, so long as velocity of money is concerned, it is a flow concept, and so long as the supply of money is concerned, it is a stock concept. Why? Because it is measured at a particular point of time, okay, in an economy, right? Now, we do not include the money with government and with the country's banking system in money supply. Why? Because they are the suppliers of money. Okay, and the amount of money held with the suppliers is not considered as a part of the supply of money. Okay, the supply of money is considered only that money, that amount of money which is held by public and other institutions, organizations, except the government and the country's banking system. Overall, let us define the supply of money once more. Supply of money means total stock of money available in circulation of an economy at a point of time. That is called supply of money. Okay? And in supply of money, we include only that amount of money who demand it, who demand money. We do not include the money of those who supply it, but we include the money of those in supply of money who demand it, okay, for different purposes. Okay, now let us discuss the different components of money supply in an economy, particularly in respect of India. As students, you know, the money supply of an economy in context of India is basically classified into four components. Or you can say that there are four components of money supply in an economy. These components are usually called M1, M2, M3 and M4. Okay, let us discuss all these four one by one. When we say M1, M1 is the first component of money supply that includes three, which are CC plus DD plus OD. Okay, that means the M1 component of money supply includes currency notes and coins held with the public and other institutions and organizations. Public includes this. DD means demand deposits with commercial banks. This is that deposit which can be withdrawn anytime on demand by issuing the check. And OD includes the deposits with the central bank or RBI. Okay. What are the deposits with central bank or RBI? These deposits are mainly by the public financial institutions of the country like NABARD, HUDCO, etc. and by the foreign central banks and foreign governments, and by the international financial institutions like IMF, World Bank, etc. So, when we say OD, it refers to other deposits with the central bank or RBI by these agencies. So, M1 is equal to CC plus DD plus OD. Okay? When we say M2, the second component of money supply, then it includes M1 plus deposits in saving bank account of post office organization. People usually save a part of their income in saving bank account of post office also. So in M2 we include M1 plus saving with post office. So long as M3 is concerned, it includes M1 plus net time deposits with the commercial banks. Okay. And finally, when we say M4, it includes M3 plus all deposits with the post office organization other than national savings certificates. So, we may conclude that money in an economy, money in circulation of an economy is found in different forms, which are broadly classified into four components called M1, M2, M3 and M4. But according to your syllabus, you have to study only the three components of M1. Okay, already we have discussed. So better you go in detail of money supply and its various components from the textbook, and if you want to discuss something with me, then you may communicate. Okay, now the question arises, who makes the supply of money? Who ensures the supply of money in an economy? The main suppliers of money in an economy are the government, the central bank or RBI, and the commercial banks. Okay. The government in fact supplies money by issuing the coins of all denominations and some selected currency notes of 1 rupees or 2 rupees in India that is now not in circulation. Earlier, it used to be issued by the government. Okay. The second supplier of money in the circulation is the central bank or RBI, which issues currency notes, okay, of all denominations as per instructed by the government and as per requirement of the economy. Okay. The third supplier of money is commercial banks, who ensure, who make supply of money by creating credit. And how money is supplied by commercial banks through credit creation, we shall discuss later on in coming topics. Okay. So students, till now I have finished the chapter money. Okay. Better you go through this chapter in detail from the textbook and then make a conversation with me and then do the related questions. Okay. Tomorrow I will start the next chapter, that is banking. Okay. Thank you.